Ricky Luca was 7, and his parents were older and meaner. Got off the school bus. And his hands were tangled in my hair. It hurt. And I watched clumps of my hair fall to the ground and blow away.
Everybody was bald.
He called me a bastard. He called everyone that.
I ever run across him, he gon' crack his head, drink his blood like wine.
He chased me. He was biting me on my front porch.
Jolene, 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 I'm begging of you, please don't take my man.
He wanted to be loved. He wanted me to love him.
The wall is high, the black bond, the big of my arms, and I'm sliding close in under the sun. The sky will split, and the planets will shift.
I love you. I want to kiss you. God damn it, you fucker. I want to be alone.
one day, when we were older, I beat Ricky with a telephone cord in an alley.
He really got nailed.
This time he was crying. And I still felt helpless. Not just of Ricky.
I ain't planning on getting busted.
One day, a man in a nice car tried to grab me off the street. He wanted to take me where he wanted to go. He wanted to do what he wanted to do. And it didn't matter if it made me sick. He was gonna do it anyways. Grandma said, bad things, they happen to bad people, so don't hang around them.
On goes the river, out past the mill, away down the valley, away down the hill. Way down the river, 100 miles or more, other little children will bring my boats ashore.
I was in my dad's Chevy truck when I watched a station wagon full of people flip over and blow up. Tragedy, that can happen to anyone. On a hot, humid day in July 1979, a woman walking along Nisky Lake Road in southwest Atlanta spotted a human leg on the ground. When the police arrived, they found the bodies of two teenage boys, Alfred Evans and Edward Hope Smith. 27 more children were found in the next 2 years. I never knew them, but I will never forget them. Because when these children were killed, every child died a little. My faith in the world was swiped from under my feet. And I thought of the day I was born, so proud of this life, and yet so uncertain of the world I had become a part of.
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for purple mountain majesties above the fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee.
My grandmother, she always wanted me to be like one of those sweet little white girls who was some people's dream of what was right in the world.